Flory Models daily vlog. Here we are on the 7th of October 2015 and been working quite hard today on the actual Starfighter, really in depth. As I say, this one's covering a lot of the basics, but extremely in depth, and some other ideas, different ways of doing things and everything else. So it's a real sort of multimedia way of doing this one. Okay, this is going to be a metal finish, as we know, and we keep going on about. It's all going to be about using metallizer paints and things. Biggest drawback to them is they show everything. So if you've got a wonky panel line, if you've got a little bit, you can't hide it in normal weathering. So this particular one, we're actually been going through and actually doing all the rescribing, re-riveting, and absolutely everything else like that, as you can imagine, all the way through this one. So you can see it's really looking the part, a little bit of black on that tail, obviously a few marks that I'm not happy with. But basically we've been looking at blending in these intakes, so different ways of actually rescribing, and to be honest, using different tools. Now, what I've been using, obviously, the classic P cutter going through and doing it freehand, which is not my usual way of doing it, but recently I've been obviously seeing a lot of other people, especially sort of the master modelers in Japan, things like that, the way they do it freehand, and to me it's always like oof. But it's learning to use the tool, and we speak about it in this a lot, and I cover it in depth, and hopefully you can see we've got some very nice, very subtle, and it's all done completely freehand on this, by just generally jigging it back and forth and bringing it, and you have great control about how it goes through, as well as using as well up here on the spine running down there, actually using razor saw blades for actually doing it and working it around. To be honest, we did the entire of the nose with the razor saw blade, just whip it around and everything else like that. Obviously it's all practice and things, but generally, you know, practice makes perfect. You take your time with it, master it and everything else. Then we did a lot down the back here. You can see it's polished up, but re-riveting, because we've got so much of it going on down there. So generally we're all okay. You see the cockpit's all painted up, that's ready now. To be honest, I'll be filming after this using the mask set, putting them on. We're going to attach the canopy onto this one, and then to be honest, tomorrow it's all about primer. So one thing came up though is our friends over at Models I'll Go, John, sent me a couple of things the other day which I haven't had a chance to look at, and this one came up in the forum the other day. Somebody's talking about it, and I've had it here, to be honest, almost a fortnight, sorry John. But anyway, what we've actually got is two products that he gets direct out of Japan, and they sell on Models I'll Go, so please go and have a look. Now, Models I'll Go are famous, for me anyway, for sending me one of the best tools I've used in years, which was the Alex Scraper. John didn't know much about them, just thought I might have a go with it, and I love this thing, and I've obviously told you guys, and you guys going out and doing it. Absolutely fantastic for something so simple of a bit of pressed steel. It is amazing. Okay, so this is their latest thing, and as you can see, it looks like a claw off a dinosaur. Actually, it's photo etched. Now, I've never used it, as you can tell, because obviously we're getting it out of the packet the first time ever. How do we get in here? Oh, let's go back old school. Okay, so actually what we've got, I don't want to bend it because it is a one, but basically it is a scribing tool, as you can see down here. Now, it comes in various thicknesses, and this is the 0.15, so it's extremely fine. It's the middle of the road. They do a 0.1, 1.5 and a 2. Okay, but generally this is what we're talking about. It's designed as a sort of freehand scriber. Now, to be honest, having never used it before, I'm not going to start running around my Starfighter with it, but I do have a old friend here, if I could even get it out of the packet. Sorry, my knives have all moved. Blade. I do have an old friend which we can try it with. Now, originally, I thought the tip of it was bent. I don't know how well you can see that. It's got a slightly different sheen to it. It's not. That's actually how it's been milled. It's been obviously toughened, I assume, on that edge. But it is what it says. It is literally a photo etch. And it's got this bead on here, which is just stuck on each side. Obviously it's to make it more easier to handle, pick it up off the bench, things like that. So, sorry Buster, you're up. Okay, what we've got here is poor Buster's about to meet his maker again. And as I say, never use this, I don't know what it's about. Well, I'm gonna try and use the technique I've been using before just to see how well this goes. So what we're gonna do is just gonna follow in a panel line. My immediate thing is, it seems as if I'm too far away from the blade. So we're just gonna try it a little bit closer. The blade is extremely fine, and I'm just worried to death about doing it. Now, as we know, this has had a million coats of paint in this. So I'm rescribing through layers and layers of paint. Uh, actually, you know, we're not too bad with this at all. It's just finding a comfortable position to try and use this. The one thing you do notice, it is extremely clean cutting. It's not dragging and pulling through and everything else. Now, I know we're going through paint here, and some of this paint is so thick that it's horrendous. But what I'm trying to do is re-put in the panel lines that are all down here, freehand. If we just try it with a tool, let's have a go down here just to see what we can do. Okay, so we're just going to put it in. Very nice, actually. I have to say, it's got a very nice clean cut to it. Let's just run this down here. One of the things I like about it is that if you wanted to get into an area such as you can see, we've got very little detail left down here to follow, but if you wanted to get into something like here and get into an area, I'm just trying to find something like, you know, if you were doing this curve here, let's just assume you wanted to come back through here. The normal problem you would have is obviously getting right down into that corner. Okay, so we're just going to do a couple of swipes. Now we're actually down into plastic now, you can probably see, but it's very fine and it cuts in beautifully and gets right down into your angles. So let me just have a quick more play on the freehand, seeing as I'm now into all my freehand scribing. Okay. Now, these panel lines are so soft that they're really non-existent. So we can just try it around these just to see what we get. But actually, yeah, it seems, it's one of those things, it looks extremely fragile. I can't even see the panel line here. So we're gonna rough guess it. Okay. But it actually has that sort of lull you into a false sense of security. Sorry, we're winging it now, freehanding a lot of this just to see how it goes. Okay, so if we were to be pulling this down here, just for argument's sake. Okay, but now I'm using it, you can see it's not too bad at all. It's one of these weird ones, but it's very nice how it gets right down into corners. It gets into all the shapes. Ooh, slightly off that, sorry. So much for my fantastic freehand scribing. Okay. But it does tend to give you some very nice control and everything else. I don't know how fine you could get it. Say if you wanted to come in down these ledges here. No, pulled off a little bit there. Yeah, it's not so, don't like it so close. It's a more of a hold back type of tool for your freehanding it. Okay, but if you were coming in, let's just do some broad strokes here down the back. Okay, if we were coming in here, just to join this up, the great thing is, see, the point gets right into the corner. Okay, and you can actually put it right down into these corners with no problems at all. You can see we've lost all our panel lining here, so we're winging it. One of the nice things about it, again, is because of the thinness of it, you can get it into those corners, but also, like down in here, it should be good enough to stable itself in anything else that you've got. Okay. No problem at all, but generally, now I'm using this thing and getting used to it. As I say, first time using it. I have to say, it's quite nice. It does clean out the lines well, Bearing in mind, Buster's had like a million coats of everything over it, but generally, hopefully you can see, not too bad at all. It works, it does the job and everything else. It gets nicely into corner areas. I don't know how long it'd last. I assume this is some toughened bit of something. It's not just like your normal sort of photo etch, but there you go. It's by Alec again. You can see it just there, the holly, okay, and everything else. In the 0.15, I'd say they do it a 0.1 and a 0.2. I think in the 1.5 is probably the way to go. I can't imagine the thinner one would be any better unless you're doing really small scale stuff. But generally, as you can see down here on the Starfighter, the engraving is ultra, ultra fine on this. It's still one of my favorite kits for this, as being ultra fine and everything else like that. So you might want to get yourself probably like the 0.15 and the 0.1, and that way you've got all the bases covered on that. But that really is very, very nice. Let's say something a little bit different. First time I've used it, I did think the end was bent. It's not. It's obviously a toughened carbon type steel for this one, a bit like the scraper itself, but generally very, very nice. It is flexible. You don't want to be bending this around, but it does, it's more comfortable than it looks. Originally I thought holding it was going to be horrible and it wasn't going to be very nice, but actually that's not too bad at all. Now, second up, we have some tape. Now, we all know Dymo tape. I'm sure we've got some around here somewhere. Yep. Dymo tape, the usual thing, cut it, stick it down and everything else. Apparently this is the sort of new way of doing it. So what we'll do is just hoof a staple out here. Okay. And then that should enable us to see exactly what we've got. So just down in here, be interested to see how thick this is. Because the trouble with Dymo tape is you've got to go around, you've got to peel the backing off and everything else like that. This, apparently, you don't have that trouble. So, I do my orange scissors, here they are, okay. So we just snip off an end. It's even quite hard to cut this stuff, it's very thick. Now, I don't think this is going to be bending around corners, but the idea is you've got it on your thing, easy to handle, ready to go. So, assuming you did have a panel line, and you had no reference for it, and you wanted it on a curve or something else like that, let's do it under here. You can take your tape. All right, we've got a panel line just down in here. We can pop it down and follow. Okay, and then with this guy, we can just come along then, and we're pushing up against it and letting the scribe do all its work. Couple of passes. Okay, so that's pretty good. Got a lift, forget that we're peeling paint. Okay, let's try another one. And this time we're going to try and curve and bend it just a little bit. So just to see if we can, we'll get a slight curve going. It will allow a little bit of curvature. Sorry, Buster. Okay, so yeah, it does work, and that's the third time of using it. Let's try again. Stick it down. Actually, it does seem to be holding. Let's bring out the big gun, see how it works up against a bigger blade. See, this is the only trouble. When you're using it against a... You see, it's jumping over the top. With a finer blade, no problem at all. But with this guy, it's a little bit fine. It's okay with this. Let me just try the other side. Using a very fine blade, but it's not liking a big pea cutter over this. Let's try and stick it down again. How many is that? 3, 4. We've torn the edge slightly with it as well. Okay, so we're just going to come in. Okay, is that 4? Back up here. So, apart from now, I've just dropped it somewhere. Here it is. 5. Right, let's try it again, just to see. Okay. And this is primed model. You can see this is 6 times. This is definitely better than your Tamiya tape, your normal Dymo tape, because normal Dymo tape will not go 6 times being pushed down. And this is a primed surface. We are pulling up against it. Okay, So now, just for reference, we're just going to stick this down a few more times just to see how many more times. So this technically would be your seventh pass going over it. Okay, then let's just assume we were down here. 7, 8. Okay. Starting to lose it a little bit now. Technically 9. And it's still holding. Okay, let's try it on a curve. 11. Actually, I must admit, I'm quite impressed now, because Dymo tape, you cannot do it more than 3 or 4 times. 12. And we got a big lump of paint stuck on this. Now, this is the nasty side of Busto, as you can see. Curving around here. Starting to fail now, admittedly. 13. Okay, it's looking a little bit worse for wear underneath here. 13. Starting to come off there. So 13 reuses. Actually, I think that's quite generous. Now, I don't know how much these things are. You'll have to pop over to Models or Go to see. But down here, which is this 3 millimeters wide tape. I don't know if they do it in different ones. I probably got to imagine it's probably about 3 meters in length, I would have thought, because it's 3 by 30 down there. I don't think it's 30 meters of this for a minute. So I'm short of, you know, don't know how much is on there. Doesn't actually say. But they actually call it carving guide tape, which I do probably mean translation. It's going to be rescribing type tape to butt up against. Yes, it's very good, very handy. Is it better than Dymo tape? Probably, because the trouble with Dymo tape is, one, you don't stick sort of, you know, probably 15 times if it was clean, okay? And also you have to cut this down each time you use it, and it's a pain to get the backing off and all the rest of it. For something quick and easy and all the rest of it, then that's probably an ideal tape. So yeah, that definitely gets my thumbs up. Shame I haven't had time to use it on that one. But definitely showing it on Buster, I don't think that's too bad at all. I think that worked really, really well. So there we go. That's two little tools for your hobby shop wish list, shall we say. That's your Holly Alec Scriber, so that's A-L-E-C, okay, Scriber. As I said, different flavors in that one. You can have it in the 0.1, the 0.15, or the 0.2, and this is your, tape, okay, carving tape. Again, you could then put it down and use it just as you would do your Dymo tape. Works quite well. Maybe with a traditional pea cutter, it might tear the edges a bit, but definitely with your finer blades, so like your Trumpeter 1, things like that, you're not going to have a problem with it. But I think with the big pea cutter, it does tend to carve the edges just a little bit. So there we go. That's the Holly Scriber. Definitely, I think that one, the Holly Scriber, is absolutely lovely. I might end up getting myself the different sizes just for the old toolbox. Works really well. And to have a roll of that round, if you have got a big rescribing job, it'll save you ages, because let's face it, we all flap around with Dymo tape, trying to get it apart, cutting it into slivers, peeling the back off. This is also the other thing as well, between the two, Dymo tape is very brittle, trying to get it to conform into curves, things like that, especially recessed curves, doesn't particularly like it where it pings off. This definitely gets in there a lot better and fits down there. So this is really just a thick sellotape, a very thick sellotape, but it does work very, very well. So there we go. That's about it for today. Thank you for joining us for this little mini tool review and everything else. The next part of the actual F104 is up on the site now, so you can go ahead and see that one. And obviously that's part two. Doesn't quite get us to this area. Still talking about the construction, bring the two halves together. It talks about us taking care of this hole, which, as you can see, is completely seamless. Now, this is that hole that we made wrong. We over drilled it and that to fill it. So we use a little bit of Steinel Res down in there. Not Steinel Res even. Styrene filler down in there just to get rid of that, and it's taken care of. But there we go, that's the F104 looking nice. As I say, get some primer on that tomorrow and we'll all be good, and then again on Monday and everything else. So we'll catch you all tomorrow for a look at what's happening in the forum, the group build, and the SIGs. So until tomorrow, everybody, happy modeling, take care.